bad. Not good, but it's not bad. Okay, what's your cut of it?
We're a page short on the topics around town section.
Okay, so what? You write a page comparing the views from the Chrysler and the Empire State Observation Tower.
Yeah, which view is the best?
They're both advertisers. Call it a draw. Say, Bob, what do we buy this month that's funnier, did we?
Funny. Did you by any chance read these?
All right, use one of my last year's pages. They were reprinting it by request.
Okay. Whose request?
Mine.
Oh, yours?
Yes. Where are those criticisms on the Russian singers? I got 3 hours to get this magazine out. I can never find anything I want.
Well, it's a monthly magazine. You've only had 4 weeks to prepare it.
Well, I'm busy. Tell them to the dictaphone.
You've only had 4 weeks.
Keeley! Keeley!
Nobody hears me around the place.
Keeley!
Yes, sir.
Bring me the proofs of those art galleries. I'm ready for them.
Coming right up.
How about another criticism on those silly singers? Get Miss G in here with a pad.
Miss G and a large pad. Did you by any chance hear the singers?
I don't know. I might have already. You ready?
Boiled again. For 5 years, you've been reviewing singers, dancers, concerts, recitals, boiled. Never once have you gone to one of these things sober. How do you know what you're writing about?
What are you worried about? All you've got invested in this magazine is money. I've got brains.
Say.
No cracks. You're the silent partner of this firm. Now you keep it that way. All right. Let's see. What did I call those yodelers? The Russian singers. That's good enough. All right, let's go. Russian entertainment, disappointing. Repertoire, familiar. Bass section, favorable. Russian ambassador present, seemed pleased.
Can't say the same for the audience?
Can't say the same for the audience? Yeah, that's good. Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. What do you got there now?
The recital of the Russian art singers at town hall last night was reminiscent of the retreat from Moscow. The artists from the land of vodka, it must be reported in the interest of art and truth, did not cover themselves with glory. Burdened with a familiar repertoire and a bass section that sounded slightly capitalistic, the gentleman from...
Gentleman from Indiana, your father, anything, but that's what I want. How do you like it? It's all right, isn't it? That's when I'm at my best. Under pressure. Back against the wall.
And drunk.
And drunk. No!
Larry, darling!
Hello, baby. How is
oh,
it?
Oh, you're busy. Larry, you promised me something last night.
Yeah, I'll look for the necklace tonight. Yeah, say, Swanson, bring in those dramatic criticisms right away, will you?
You said we were getting married tomorrow.
Fine, I'll look at that coat.
You said we were getting married tomorrow.
No, did I? It's a great idea. We'll drive the credit some more night, girl. Hello, call back later. Yeah, you too. Okay. Swanson, drop whatever you're doing. Come in here right away.
Oh, darling, I'm so happy. I always wanted to be married on a Thursday.
Well, you always have been.
Where's that cover? Where's that cover?
Darling, I haven't a thing to be married in.
Oh, wear anything. Larry's wearing a shroud.
Get a check from Miss G. Where is Swanson?
Oh, you sweet thing. I'll tell her to make it a blank check now. I know you're busy. Goodbye, precious.
Goodbye, darling. Hello, Swanson. Now,
look here. If you think that you're going to marry, that's...
Chief, I got bad news.
Well, now, wait a minute. One at a time. What?
If you know that collection of letters to the editor? Well, Sam has misplaced them. We haven't a single letter to print.
All right.
Do you know that Clara's already won 3 breach of promise suits and that you're all primed to be the fourth?
Well, I'll tell you what I do. Write 2 letters.
About what?
Write one from Mrs. Borker praising the magazine. Write another one signed the constant reader Perez in the magazine. Wait a minute. Make the first one twice as long as the second one. Now what?
You know Clara for 3 weeks, and what do you do? Propose marriage to her. Is that the way you make conversation? We're having a cold spell right now. Why couldn't you talk about the weather?
Well, I'm tired. Claire and I are going to settle down.
Oh, yeah, I get it. I get it. Clara, the home and fireside
girl.
Yeah,
the pipe and the slippers and the bag and everything else. Yeah. I'm going to be married. I'm going to drink to my future. Well, that's great. As empty as Swanson's head, I got a future and nothing to drink to it with. Say, look. Harold, do me a favor. Run out and get some Gay and Frisky, will you?
Yeah, a whole pound.
What?
Gay and Frisky.
Whiskey!
Oh, Gay and Frisky is whiskey.
Yeah.
Oh, G and F is W. Yes, of course.
Yes, a whole bottle of G and...
Miss G, right away, will you please?
What? Again?
Miss G, I wonder if you'll telephone to Mr. MacArthur's apartment and have his valet pack a whole lot of clothes. Then you and Swanson had better take charge in the office here. Start collecting material for next month's issue. Mr. MacArthur and I are going away for about 3 weeks or more.
Going away?
Going away, Miss G.
Where, Mr. Brandon?
Well, as a matter of fact, I haven't given that the slightest... There.
Thank you.
Mexico.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, yes, yes, you attend to the luggage. And you too, you look strong and husky. You carry that. Be careful. We'll welcome you to Europe when all these skies are sunny and blue. The new arrival will be the grand revival. He's the diamond gate with my new... Gentlemen, gentlemen, please, not so loud. My friend is asleep, and you'll waken him.
English not so good looking. Silencio!
Gracias, señor, gracias.
Careful, careful. Don't jiggle him, boys. Careful, caution.
Gracias, señor, gracias.
Good day.
What's good about it?
Just sleepy.
You've been cheating again, Jose.
Rita, my dove. We was two gentlemen engaged in a game of chance, and as it happened, I won.
You mean, as it always happens, you won?
Rita, my pet, I resign from card playing, I promise.
What will people say? My uncle, my manager, a cheat. Can't you see what you're doing to me? I'm a dancer, not an adventurous.
Rita, my pet, you are a Spanita, the greatest dancer in all the Americas, Europe, Asia, oh, not to forget Africa, eh?
I'm tired, darling. I'm trying to get a rest here. How can I have peace of mind when I have to keep an eye on you?
Well, it will be no longer necessary to worry. I promise, eh? I promise.
All I gotta do is to turn up the ace of hearts and I win $100.
That is all, senor. You see, it is very simple.
All right, now you are. Now you shuffle them up. I'll take them out.
You pick.
Yep. You ready?
Ready.
Here we go.
Yes, Jenkins, another whiskey and soda. All right, I'm leaving.
Say, now look, Harold. I don't want to presume, but don't want to be curious. But just for the records, where am I?
Guess.
Oh, a game, huh?
And you can have the regulation three guesses, too, you know. Mm. No peeking.
Museum of Art?
No.
Heaven.
Getting warmer.
Hey, where's Clara?
She's 3,000 miles away.
3,000? Where'd she go?
She didn't go. She stayed. We went.
What do you mean, we went? Where?
Mexico. Da-dum-de-de-de-caliente.
Now, this wasn't my idea.
My dear boy, you haven't had a consecutive idea in 15 years, as you know. As a matter of fact, you haven't been conscious for the past 24 hours. Last night, I poured you into an aeroplane, and here we are. I'm saving you from Clara.
I'm now beginning to remember where I started to forget.
Good.
Gay and frisky.
Yes.
I had a drink.
Yes.
I passed out.
Yes.
You shanghaied me.
Yes.
And this?
Da-dee-da.
Mexico!
Somebody told you.
Well, you didn't have to do this. I'm not the marrying kind.
You're not, but Clara is.
What is that?
Music.
You sure are charitable. I've heard all about this tropical music. It never stops. I hate the tropics. I am back to New York tonight.
Uh-huh. That's gratitude.
I gotta get back to work.
They'll get along all right without you. Now, will you listen to reason?
I will if you stop that music.
I'll try. No shenanigans.
Word of honor.
Wrong hand. Like a baby on this Arabian night.
Hello, operator. Get me New York. Yeah. I want to speak to Claremont 82234. I want to speak to Miss Clara Thorne.
Gentlemen, in the north is San Francisco, and they're crazy about music up there. So please, on your marks, one, two, show.
English not so good looking.
Good evening, senor.
Please, I'm busy here. You speak English?
Yeah, well, of course. American Court, carry it in the net. The international beverages, 17 and a half.
Yes, but you didn't have it on margin. We've just flown 3,000 miles, and we're very, very tired. Now, I've tried to explain to these charming gentlemen. I pointed it out to them. I've drawn a diagram. Would you please ask them in their own lovely tongue to stop singing and go away somewhere, anywhere?
I happen to be the manager of this quartet, senor. I don't argue. I shall go into conference with my clients. Oye, muchachos, aquí está la cosa. No dejen de cantar hasta que pague el americano.
They say yes.
For providing. You know, senor, these artists make their bread and tequila by singing all day, picking up a dollar here and a dollar there. Sometimes they make as much as $25. And, of course, if you desire to...
I? Oh?
Yeah.
Oh?
Yeah.
Oh.
Gracias, señor.
Hombre, gracias. Qué bueno. Vengas, muchachos. A buscar una chamba por algo.
Hello. Oh, hello, Clara, darling. This is Larry.
Well, fancy that. Did you know we had a date to be married this noon?
Oh, well, look, honey, I don't think you better wait up for me. I'm going to be a little late. Yeah, I'm in Mexico. Caliente.
You what? You where?
Well, don't scream at me. I can explain everything. I'll be back just as soon as I can. Well, he can't intimidate me. Bring two pitchers of ice water. My head's splitting.
To what? Two pitchers of what?
Now, look here, young fellow. If you let that calculating, gold-digging blonde get you back to New York, I wash my hands of you.
Well, you better get to washing, because I'm on my way.
Now, Larry, listen. Now, does it do me any good to see you unhappy? No. Do I make anything out of interfering with your love affairs? No. Now, you're an intelligent fellow.
Why do I always have to be intelligent? Why can't I be a sap once in a while, have some fun like other people? And I got a job to take care of. What's going to become of Manhattan Madness without me?
I'll tell you what's going to become of it. It's probably going on to bigger and better things. What good have you been around there lately anyway with your diets of cocktails and that blonde? Huh? Now, do me a favor. Larry, crawl back into bed, will you? Have a good night's sleep. And then tomorrow, when you wake up, if you still want to go back, I won't say another word. Word of honor.
It's the wrong hand.
That's the boy. That's the boy. Jangled nerves. That's what it is. A few days down here in this lovely, peaceful, soothing atmosphere, you'll be a new man.
Oh, I don't want to be a new man.
Shh, quiet, quiet.
I just want to be the same old man I've always been. I like being an old man. That settles it. Pack the bag. Pay the bill. Get the plane tickets. I'm on my way to New York and Times Square in a little peace and quiet. It's an overproduction of musicians around this joint.
Be very careful. Caution, you know, moderation and no violence. There isn't a decent jail for miles.
I want to tell you something else.
Yes?
Get in touch with the American consul.
The American consul?
Yeah, the American consul. International complications are on their way.
Oh, my word.
Hey, listen, you canaries. I'm going to count three, and if you're not gone, you'll be playing music at your own funeral.
English, not so good. Looking.
One.
Caution.
Two.
Moderation. You better show.
Three. Now will you get out of here or will I...
Don't stop the music. It's beautiful.
Señor, la familia, el green. El señor, saque la... take it out. Do your photography.
What's that big yellow thing up there? It's all over me.
Oh, that? That's what they call sunshine.
Oh, I've been dodging that for years.
Take a nicer picture, senor. Nicer picture.
We don't want any pictures.
Nicer fotografia, senor.
Get one of the eagle.
No eagle, senor. That's a parrot. Parrot, senor. Parrot.
Hello, Mr. MacArthur. Don't you remember me? Tiptoe in Greenwich Village.
When Irish eyes are smiling, sure it's like
Pat Casey.
Right, but I'm Pedro Casanova down here. You know, it's a long, long story.
Yeah, but too long. Tell me back in New York.
It's like a morning's rain.
We ordered our breakfast by telephone, Mr. Brandon and Mr. MacArthur.
Oui, bien, senor.
Yesterday she was an angel. Today she's a goddess. Tomorrow ought to be interesting.
Poetry before breakfast?
Oh, sure. Before breakfast, before dinner, before...
Oh, I don't blame you.
You were a question.
Gracias.
Finished. Let's go.
You know, Harold, that's probably the only girl that could ever keep me in Mexico. Well, I'll go further than that. For a gal like that, I take out citizenship paper.
Buenos dias, senor.
You see, he snorts at you. That's what you get when you cheat people.
You know, I'd almost give up drinking to meet her.
I've got an idea. Excuse me.
Go ahead.
I beg pardon.
Well, what is it?
Would you know the name of the very charming young woman who passed just a moment ago?
What young woman?
Well, she was accompanied by a man, apparently her father. I noticed you exchanged greetings.
Greetings? I'd like to exchange a good smack in the jaw with that crook.
Oh, I understand, yes. I met the gentleman myself last night.
You did? How much?
$25.
He clipped me for $200. Sit down.
Of course, he was a little late when I met him, so he was probably very tired.
Can you pick the ace? Oh.
The young lady,
Well, she's the come-on. But he didn't need it from me. I took it straight.
You mean she's a decoy?
My boy, it's the old army game.
That's fine.
Huh?
What? Did you know the name?
Well, he calls himself Gomez. Probably Mexican for Jesse James.
Oh, Mr. James.
Jesse.
Jesse James. Oh, I see. Thank you for the warning, Mr.
Biggs. Joe Biggs from Pineapple, Oklahoma.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Biggs.
Now, ace, king, queen, ace. Darn it.
Nice picture. Senor, take a nice picture. Yeah, nice picture.
No, please, no picture. Did you see a good-looking young lady in a sports outfit accompanied by a middle-aged man, not so good-looking?
Me don't speak English, senor.
Oh, I see.
They passed a few minutes ago.
Thank you. Which way'd they go? Oh, thank you. Muchas gracias. I beg pardon. I know we haven't met socially. If you'll wait just a minute.
Pardon me, Mr. You, in the water. Could I have a word? Oh, my. Mr.
I beg pardon.
I don't wish to intrude, but I would like to have a word with you on a very important matter.
Yes?
I'm Harold Brandon, and I've just come out from New York.
Oh, yes, Mr. Brandon.
And when I saw you here this morning, why, I...
What is the important matter?
Well, it's rather delicate.
So?
I understand that you're open for engagements.
Usually. But is that so delicate? It's only a matter of business, isn't it?
Oh, is it? Oh, of course it is, yes. A business matter. Oh. Well, we are getting off to a good start, aren't we?
But at the moment, I'm booked up quite a ways ahead.
Oh, booked up.
I might have some time in November after my tour.
Oh, you tour too?
Oh, yes. One must. One's public is everywhere.
Oh, are they? You mean all around? Oh, yes, of course they are. Yeah, here and there. And yes. Well,
Yes?
How much do you receive for one of your...
$2,000 an engagement.
$2,000? My, it pays well, doesn't it?
I don't like to boast, but I am more or less in a class by myself.
Oh, I can feel, I can see, I can believe that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, the salary is satisfactory, but it's really a question of time. You see, it would have to be immediately.
Immediately?
Yes. By immediately, I mean right now. You see, time is essential.
Oh, would you mind telling me a little more clearly just what it is you're talking about?
Oh, no, not at all, no. You see, this is it in an eggshell. I have a friend in New York who is infatuated with a woman. And I've kidnapped, that is, I brought him out here to try and snap him out of it and get him away from her.
Would you mind helping me with this oil?
On the back?
Yes.
Oh. Well, you see, I've come to the conclusion that some other influence besides the climate is necessary. You see, Clara has already won 3 breach of promise suits, and Larry is scheduled to be the 4th.
The engagement you were speaking of...
No, they're not engaged. Oh, that, yes, you see, well, that's you. You are to be this other influence.
Oh, no.
Well, I assure you it's anything but funny.
Now, where did you hear of me?
Why, through that gentleman with whom your...
My manager?
Your manager exchanged greetings.
Oh. I'm beginning to understand. Who is this unfortunate young man?
Well, his name is MacArthur. Larry MacArthur. And, we arrived only yesterday.
Is he still sleeping?
Oh, sound asleep. No. We had breakfast together this morning. You must have noticed him.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my. Do you mind if I dunk too?
Why, certainly not. So did you say his name is MacArthur?
MacArthur, yes. M-A-C. He's a very brilliant chap. He's the editor of Manhattan Madness and all that sort of thing.
Manhattan Madness?
Yes, that very smart magazine. You must know it.
Oh, yes, slightly. He's in the midst of an unfortunate romance.
Oh, most unfortunate.
Your preposition, it begins to interest me.
Oh, really? Really? And you think you can find the time?
I'm sure I can.
Oh, my. And it's a bargain?
It is.
Thank you.
Now, have you any ideas as to how we should start this thing?
Oh, no. I stop right there. I wouldn't attempt to advise an artist of your caliber.
Well, you bring your friend here.
Here.
I dive into the water, cry for help. Your friend is gallant. He rescues me. Well, it's all very simple.
It's all very old, isn't it? Then it's always worked. Why experiment? I'll start the machinery going at once.
Grand. Oh, Mr. Brandon.
Yes?
Your shoes.
New ones. Night and night.
Jose, will you pardon me? I have some interesting news for you, Jose.
Yes?
Do you remember the name of the man who gave me a very mean review when I danced a year ago in New York?
Do I remember, eh? Have I for 1 minute allowed his name to slip my memory? Have I not cursed him for a year? Did he not cause me to lose $1,000 in commissions on account of canceled recitals? Remember him, his name is engraved on my heart in letters of blood.
read some of it for me.
Well, look here.
when the dance becomes merely a progression of a bag of bones across the stage, I will appreciate the dancing of the curiously famous Espanita. The senorita made her New York debut at the garden last night and left me strangely cold when...
That's enough. I know the rest of it by heart. When I eat onion soup, I like it with onions. I like my dancing with at least a pinch of that certain appeal. Spanita's appearance last night was certainly onion soup without the onions. Not even one fragrant Spanish scallion. So, I'm a bag of bones, am I? So, I haven't even a pinch of appeal, Mr. MacArthur.
What's the matter with you?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all, except that I've just met her.
Her?
Her?
Oh, her. You mean the angel, the goddess. When? Where?
Why, at
how?
The pool, at the pool. She smiled, and I... Well, here, where are you going?
To the pool. You're going to introduce me.
I? Oh, not I. I had enough trouble in New York with you because of women. I'll have none of it. You're on your own.
To the pool. Salute, people. Say this, stuff.
Are you hurt?
I'm dying. Ah, it's my death rattle.
You're not hurt at all.
Hey, listen. Wait a minute. What did you say?
I said you're not hurt.
Oh, I'm worse than hurt. I'm embarrassed. You see, I was supposed to rescue you. I must have hit my head on the bottom or something. Very upsetting. Me that swum the English Channel.
Well, you're quite all right. I shall leave you.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Listen. After all, you saved my life, and I'm recommending you for a Carnegie Medal. What's your name?
Rita Gomez.
Rita Gomez. That's a swell name. That'll look great on a medal. Well, now, I'll tell you, Rita.
Rita?
Oh, well, sure, you wouldn't want me to be formal with you after you've saved my life. How about coming over this morning and telling you how grateful I am?
Can't you tell me now? Later, I'll be busy.
Busy doing what?
You must know, writing letters, taking a siesta.
Oh, I'm a crack letter writer, and how I can siest?
Sorry, no.
Well, listen. How about this afternoon?
In the afternoons, I have cocktails in my bungalow at 4. Alone.
Oh. Well, I see no reason for disturbing your routine. You'll go right ahead and have your cocktails. But I'll be with you.
Make yourself comfortable.
Thank you.
At the first sign of rain, you can come in. Tell me, what are you doing in Caliente?
Well, I'll tell you, it's sort of... it's an unforeseen vacation.
Happy holiday.
Thank you. Happy holiday to you. What's keeping those clouds?
What is it you do when you're not vacationing?
Well, so you are interested. All right, you'll have a history of my life. I'll give you a confidential report on Larry MacArthur.
Sorry. Nobody at home. You haven't told me yet. What do you do, Mr. MacArthur?
I'm an editor.
Of a newspaper?
Mm-mm.
Perhaps a magazine?
Mm-mm.
Say, is that all you can do?
Mm-hmm.
You're a very rude man.
Oh, Rita, I couldn't be rude to you.
I've asked you of what you are the editor.
I'm the editor of Madness.
Madness?
Manhattan Madness.
Manhattan Madness?
Mm-hmm.
My favorite magazine.
Oh, that's what everybody says.
So brilliant.
Thank you.
Especially the criticism. So witty, so devastating, so completely destructive.
Oh, well, I'll tell you, Rita. Our specialty is honest criticism.
How nice. I'll leave you to your editing, Mr. MacArthur. I have work of my own to do. My pillow?
Oh, yes, yes. Your pillow.
Thank you.
Welcome to you and welcome to me. You're welcome as you can be. It's caliente.
Hello? Yes. Thank you very much. Mr. MacArthur says he will meet you in the bar at 3.
Thank you.
I cannot understand, my lord, why you are constantly in the company of a man like Senor MacArthur. If a man would call me a bag of bones, onion soups without the onions, I would crush him like a grape.
No violence, Jose. That's not the way.
Well, let me have my cards then, eh?
No.
But he should be made to pay for his insult.
He is going to pay.
Oh, he is, eh?
Not money.
No.
Although I could collect $2,000.
Aye, $2,000, my plum, eh?
His friend, Mr. Brandon, offered me that much to intrigue Mr. MacArthur.
And you accepted, of course, eh?
Seems there is a woman in New York I must make him forget. I agree because it suits my purpose. I am going to humiliate Mr. MacArthur, Jose. I am going to make him admit that I am more than a bag of bones. I'm going to make him shout that I have several kinds of appeal, and then I'm going to laugh at him.
And I will help you, my butterflies, eh? Buenos dias, senor.
Why? Oh, hello.
You know, I cannot begin to tell you how happy I am that we are now associated in business.
Yes, it does make it nice. What are you talking about?
Well, my little pigeon has told me of your arrangement.
Your pigeon?
That is my client, you know.
Oh, she told you.
You see, I do all of her business for her.
Oh, I see. You must be awfully busy touring and swimming.
Oh, yes. Oh, she is a great artist, senor.
Uh-huh. Well, that remains to be seen.
But alas, she is not a businesswoman, you know, senor. And to accept an engagement of this importance, of this magnitude, of course, a little something in advance.
Look here, whatever your name is. You and your client are getting enough out of this without any advance. My word, $2,000 for an adventuress? I could go to New York right now and get an adventuress for half the money.
Yeah, but you forget, you know, you're not only merely paying for the service, you know, you are paying for all those years of training, study, and hard work.
All right. I haven't time for a speech. How much do you want?
Oh, not much, you see, be $1,000.
I'll give you 250.
Oh, 500, eh?
All right, 300.
Well, as you say in your languages, okay.
Yeah, gracias, senor.
$300, eh? Well, I'm sure my little pigeon, she will do her very best. Eh?
Yes, uh-huh. How many yards did you say it was?
250 yardas.
That means in my language, 250 yards, eh? Gracias, senor.
Oh, well. Give me the putter.
night of glory when we began this story. I was afraid that it all would fade and leave nothing but sighs. Oh, what a tender feeling, for you were so appealing. I had a fear that I'd wake up, dear, and stand there rubbing my eyes. I never saw the moon till that one beautiful night, the night you gave me the right.
I beg pardon. Will you do me a favor?
And not speak English.
I never heard a tune till your eyes played me a strain.
What do you want me to do?
You see that couple dancing out there? The very pretty lady in the nice white dress? Yes. Well, would you sort of cut in?
With pleasure, senor.
For me, the starlight spoke of resting, never suggesting moments of love. It all was nothing but pretending.
Pardon me, but may I intrude? And if you want anything to do with your time but dance, don't be a sun dodger. Go on out and chase butterflies and tequila and...
Of course he may.
But it smiled on us one night, and your lips gave me the right to call you my own.
What is that? I don't see anybody else cutting in.
Oh, that's an old Spanish custom. My, they look well together, don't they? Must be a treat for her to dance with somebody who can really dance. Caution, moderation.
To phone, Mr. McCarter. Long distance from New York.
Thanks. Probably the office needs some help on one of the new issues.
Yeah. Well, ask Clara if she's still a blonde. Decided
to stay a while, yeah. I'm gonna write 10,000 words on Mexico. Our southern neighbors at work and play, their habits and hobbies, yeah. And as soon as I do a little research work on habits and hobbies, I'll fly right back to New York.
Where's Larry?
Oh, he's on the phone, long distance from Clara.
Clara?
The girl in New York.
Oh, tell me, is she very attractive, this girl in New York?
Well, she's what I call determined.
Oh, no, of course I love you. Well, I know my voice doesn't sound very convincing, but... Well, you see, honey, my voice has got to travel 3,000 miles over a wire, yeah. And that kind of a trip takes the pep out of any voice. Sure.
Don't tell me there isn't some woman down there in Caliente. And if you must write an article, I've got some habits and hobbies you can write a book about.
Now, look, as soon as I get back, I'll write you into a national byword. How's that? All right, darling. Phone you soon.
Did he escape you, Clara, darling?
Mm-hmm. He thinks he did.
I don't know.
If you were me, would you go to Mexico?
You remember that broker you chased into Canada? Oh, yes.
Oh, philanderer is no name for Larry. Do you know what they call him on Broadway?
No.
The Sultan.
Really?
Really, yes. Only a year ago in Brooklyn, there was this...
Hello. Business all settled?
Sure, just a little misunderstanding on the magazine. It's all straightened out.
Well, I think I must be going. It's getting close to 4. As you know, I always have cocktails in my bungalow at 4.
May I join you? I love outdoor drinking.
I'm announcing a change of policy. You may come in this time.
Things are looking up. Caution, moderation.
Maria, how do I look?
Hermosa, señorita. Bellissima.
I don't know if I can go through with this.
Remember the review.
Give me that perfume. Maria.
Tell me now. Don't tell me. It is real. Honey, I don't know what they call these, but it's beautiful.
I sometimes think I shouldn't wear things like this. I was once told I looked like a bag of bones.
Whoever said that's a halfwit.
I think so, too. Oh, it's beautiful here. Isn't it?
Oh, Rita.
Hello? Yes, he's here. Long distance call for you from Newark, New Jersey.
Newark.
Some more business?
Hello. No, I don't know anybody in Newark. I never did. I don't know where Newark is. Rita, I've always been pretty handy at speech making. In fact, I've even been lyric and poetic, but...
What do you want to say?
I don't know. Whatever it was pretty swell, but... I don't know, I just can't find the words. Rita, my darling, I love you.
You love me.
Buenas tardes.
Jose, I want you to meet Mr. MacArthur. This is my manager.
Mr. MacArthur.
How do you do? Perhaps I better explain. You see...
Perhaps.
Perhaps I better be going.
Adios.
Same to you, senor.
Jose, you were too soon.
Too soon, my plum?
I was just going to laugh at him.
Yeah. So I notice.
We'll ride through clover and proudly we'll stray.
Harry.
Mister.
Ah!
Yeah.
Stop that noise and read your telegram. It's on the table.
Thank you.
It's terrible, you know. You're no canary. It's an eagle screech, that's what it is. Stop it, will you? Stop it.
Harold.
What do you want?
Now listen, I've been holding out on you. Well, what's the matter? I'm in love.
Oh.
Harold, I'm in love with the most beautiful, the most divine creature in all the world.
Uh-huh.
All right, laugh if you want to, but this time it's on the level.
Uh-huh. Beautiful lyrics. How does the tune go?
No, Harold, my peccadilloes of the past...
You've had them again?
What I started to say was my peccadilloes of the past are finished. I finally met the one woman.
Yes, well, this is the third one woman in a month.
Yeah. Well, kid, I can't blame you for being cynical. I mean, after all, you've had good reason to be in the past. But this time, you're wrong.
Uh-huh. Well, it's too bad.
I'm going to marry her.
Yeah, you tell her when you... You're going to what?
I'm going to marry her. I am, that is, if she'll have me.
Marry her? Oh, my word. Oh, I never thought of that.
No, you wouldn't.
But you couldn't do a thing like that,
I'm Larry.
No, it's
that.
Preposterous.
Marvelous.
Why, that'll be all out of the plan. You couldn't marry Rita. You don't know her. You don't know who she is. She might be just another one of the... Well, you remember the girl in Brooklyn just a year ago today? I told you at the time. That girl was at least socially somebody.
Wait,
I mean, you
Carol,
could...
Listen. Now, you listen to me. I'm going to marry Rita. And after all, I don't blame you for questioning me after all the things we've been through together. But I'm going to marry her.
You're going to marry Rita over my dead body.
Mm-hmm. But Larry. Larry! Why shouldn't I get married? Live my own life.
Well, in that case, Larry, I suppose I'll have to tell you.
Oh, tell me
what? Oh, why, this Rita and this uncle of hers, you know what? They're nothing but adventurers. Now, don't get excited, but the very first day that we got here, I made a deal with Rita, a financial deal. If she could make you forget Clara, I was to pay her $2,000.
You're
no, own. No, only this morning I gave this uncle of hers a check for $300 on account. Yeah, sure. Here's the what do you call it? You know, the thing in the book here, the stub. Sorry, I had no idea that she hit you so hard. I mean, a peccadillo is sort of a... Did you see a sort of a tall chap kind of shaving?
Hey, big shot.
Good evening, senor.
I want to talk to you.
But some other time, senor. I am leaving.
You heard me. I want to talk to you now.
Well?
Get $300 from Brandon.
Books?
$300.
Oh, I seem to remember that I did.
So you and Rita were going
but
to...
I saw no harm in availing myself of the money, senor.
Oh, no, you wouldn't. Of course not.
But I beg of you not to tell her, eh?
All right. I won't tell her. Listen, from now on, you and I are going to work together. I'll make a little bargain with you. If you don't mention this conversation, I won't say a word. Is that a bargain?
A bargain? Then perhaps a little something in advance after?
Huh?
To seal the bargain, say $100, eh?
Oh, sure, that's all right. That's perfectly okay. To seal the bargain, you give me $100.
Oh, I am to give you $100?
Yeah.
Adios, senor.
Adios, senor. Begonias.
Begonias.
Petunias.
Petunias.
Gladiolus.
Gladiolas.
Jonquils.
Jonquils.
And hollyhocks.
Hollyhocks.
Once again, may I ask, why do you want to transform this place into an evil-smelling hothouse?
And marigolds, dahlias, sweet peas, and rhododendrons. That's all.
And how am I to dress? Is a nymph or a dryad?
Dress as a hollyhock.
Marigolds, dahlias, sweet peas,
R-H-O.
I can spell rhododendrons.
Well, what of it?
Can you spell rhododendrons?
Go away. Shoo. Now, for the third and last time...
Now, wait a minute. Listen, paperweight. You and Rita have been making me the fall guy long enough. Now it's my turn to start cracking the whip.
Big boy, listen to me.
Big boy, you listen to me. I know that Rita, acting under strict orders from you, stays a great spider in the fly routine. Walk into my parlor gag. Well, now, tonight, after that show in the patio, I'm going to bring Rita right here, and I'm going to stage a little scene of my own. You want to hear it?
No.
Good, well, here goes. Think only of beauty. Think only of us. Here in our bower, you a woman made for love, and I a man ready to pour the molten gold of my affection at your feet.
Well, my word. Who wrote that?
I wrote it.
Why, you're insane.
Hello. Don't know anybody in Chicago. It's a mistake. Now listen, if you're half the pal you claim to be, you leave us alone. Caballero, tonight is my turn. Think only of beauty. Think only of us.
Here in our bower, you a woman made for love?
Senor, three nice picture. You and your beautiful wife.
Oh, no, she's not my wife. But she is beautiful.
Si, beautiful.
Get one of him. He's a great subject.
Oh, no. Ah, yes. Si, senor. Si,
how
si,
do you like no, it? No, kidnapping. No, so long.
Look at here.
This has been taken in 10
years.
Sombrero?
Oh, this is just silly.
La Serapia?
Nobody wears
it. Ah, libre mexicano.
Larry?
Señor, aquí, señor.
No, no, aquí, señor. I don't want my picture taken. They look just like me.
You stay right here.
Check these things.
Oh, no, mi caballero. Don't take that off.
Why not?
You look marvelous.
Oh, do I?
Si, you come with me to my table.
Oh, I'll keep them. Yeah. Don't do that. If you knew what I've been through and the way you came rushing to my rescue, really, it was heartwarming.
Don't mention it.
Yeah. What do you want?
Mr. McCarthy, there's a long-distance call for you from Kansas City.
No calls. I don't know about it. I don't know anybody in Kansas City.
You don't know anybody
in Kansas City.
But, oh, but, Larry, it might be...
Why don't you sit down with the lady?
You come to my table.
Come, Macedo.
Yes, sir?
A pint of wine.
Oh, a wine. Quart of wine.
Oh, yes, sir.
Señoras y caballeros, ladies and gentlemen, we take great pleasure in presenting to you tonight the first number of the Caliente Review, The Lady in Red, sung by our beautiful Rosa Cuartero and featuring the internationally famous dancers, the DeMarcos. Thank you.
Met the girl who's the toast of the town, a work of art without a question, who gives your heart a queer congestion. Say, have you ever met the dream in the red velvet gown? If you will pardon my suggestion, you'd better write her number down. She's the gay young bird all the magazines feature. Upon my word, she's the zippiest creature. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
She's the valentine all the movies are after. She won't sign 'cause she really don't have to.
I declare.
Oh, the lady in red. The fellas are crazy for the lady in red. She's a bit gaudy, but lordy, what a personality. Oh, the lady in red is fresh as a daisy when the town is in bed. Dancing and dining and shining with originality. She's very proper, she's nothing more than a pill, but oh, me and oh my, you'd never stop her. She'd be a dangerous gal if she should ever meet the right guy.
Oh, the lady in red. The fellas are crazy for the lady in red. Lady in red. Is she a study? Oh, buddy, what a personality. She's got vitality.
Say, have you ever met the girl who's the toast of the town? A work of art without a question. Write her number down.
Have you ever met the girl who is the ghost of the town? A work of art without a question. Who gives your heart with congestion? Say, have you ever met the dream in the red gown? If you will pardon my suggestion, you better write her number down. She's the gay young bird, all the magazine's creature. On my word, she's the silliest creature. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Say,
best of the town. A work of art without a question, who gives your heart a queer congestion. Say, have you ever met the dream in the red velvet gown? If you will pardon my suggestion, you better write her number down. She's a gay young bird, all the magazines feature. On my word, she's a zippiest creature. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
She's a Valentine, all the movies are after. She won't sign, cause she really don't have to.
Well, I declare.
Oh, the lady in red, fellas are crazy for the lady in red. She's a bit gaudy, but lordy, what a personality. Oh, the lady in red, stretches a daisy when the town is in red. Dancing and dining and shining with originality. She's very proper, she's nothing more than a pal, but oh, me and oh my. Never stop her, she'd be a dangerous gal if she should ever meet the right guy. Oh, the lady in red, fellas are crazy for the lady in red. Is she a study? Oh, buddy, what a personality. She's got vitality. Say, have you ever met the girl who's a toast of the town?
I'm the lady in red. Can't you look in my eyes and see I wanna be led? Yoda lady dee, don't be so yeller. Hey feller, how's about a kiss or two? Oh, you heard what I said. Come on and get close to me and you'll get ahead. Don't you say no, sir, cause oh, sir, I have set my eye on you. Why, looky here, don't be so nervous. I ain't gonna bite you. Ooh, honey bunch, I could just love you to death. Don't be so nervous. Just hold your seat and set tight. It'll hug you and it'll squeeze you till you plumb out of breath. Oh, where was you bred? Why don't you give in? I ain't asking to wed. Ooh, no. Give your love to me and do me just the way I want you to.
Thank you.
so crazy for the lady in red. She's a bit gaudy, but lordy, what a personality. Oh, the lady in red is fresh as a daisy when the town is in bed.
When the town is in bed.
Dancing and dining and shining with originality.
Originality. She's very proper. She's nothing more.
Better, I've seen the best. Nijinsky, Martha Graham, Wigman, La Argentina.
Did you ever see Espanita? I believe she danced a year ago in New York.
Yes, I saw her. I reviewed her for the magazine.
I hear that as a dancer, she's marvelous.
As a dancer, she's in Harold's class.
Will you excuse me? No, no, please. You stay here and enjoy yourself. I must go and find Jose.
But you promised to have supper with me.
Sorry to disappoint you. Jose, will you please inform the manager that I will dance tomorrow night at the fiesta?
Oh, you dance, eh? Fine. For how much?
For nothing.
For nothing? Rita, my little quail, tell me that these ears of mine are deceiving me.
For nothing, Jose.
But my commissioner.
I will take care of your commission.
But Rita, you are not this type of dancer. You are a concert dancer.
It doesn't matter. I will dance tomorrow night.
The boys are all crazy for the lady in red. She's a bit gaudy, but lordy, what a personality. Oh, the lady in red.
I beg your pardon, senor, but... You are spilling that precious, that beautiful champagne.
Salud.
Thank you, monsieur. Thank you.
Oh, the lady in red. The boys are all crazy for the lady in red. She's a bit gaudy, but lordy, what a personality. Oh, the lady in red. She's a bit gaudy. Lordy, what a personality.
Now let me see. As you start to kiss me, I walk over to the balustrade. Here.
That's it exactly. And I come around here and finish the song.
Now don't forget, Espinita. You grab the whip, hit him across the face just as he sings the last word of the chorus.
I'll remember like this.
Excuse me, senorita, but now I would like to call the company for a complete rehearsal of the number right here on the set.
Splendid idea.
Let's have the orchestra too, Bella.
Si, si.
Grand.
Well? She wouldn't speak to you all day, she wouldn't even see you, and she isn't here. Now, can't you take a hint?
No, she suddenly got angry for no reason at all. Wouldn't even speak to me. Why?
Oh, well, now you're asking me.
There's a call for you from San Diego, Mr. McArthur.
Will you go away? I've been getting those calls for 3 days. That's the wrong McArthur. They're calling Fort McArthur.
Very well, sir.
Now what?
From Senorita Espanita, senor.
Who? What's this?
Señoras y caballeros, ladies and gentlemen, it is a great honor to present to you tonight the big number of our new review, Muchacha. And now a surprise. For tonight only, we have the great fortune to present in our review a world-renowned guest of the hotel, the famous La Españita. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bandit Brigade, behold a bandit who isn't afraid of anything but a Mexican maid in Caliente. Bandit afraid of Mexican maid. Jose Juan Pedro Vega Lopez. Behold the chief of a bandit brigade. Behold a bandit who isn't afraid of anything but a Mexican maid in Caliente. So tonight I'll kidnap all the moonlight and I'll steal the starlight from the sky. I'll look this brave little maid in the eye. I'll hold her up and I'll tenderly sigh. Muchacha, tonight I've got you where I want you, my muchacha.
Muchacha, muchacha.
I'll watch ya just like a cat would watch a little cucaracha.
Cucaracha!
For ransom, I ask for a handsome prize. Let it be a glance from your dancing eyes. I've got ya, and in the lingo of the gringo, I've so hot ya, muchacha, for you.
The chief isn't out for a hold of tonight.
He's out for an hour of wild delight.
And if he's after some treasure at all,
he'll find it inside of a Spanish shawl.
He's out for some plunder that's precious and rare.
A pair of red lips and raven hair.
You said it, Chango!
I'll watch ya just like a cat would watch a little cucaracha. For ransom I ask for a handsome prize. Let it be a glance from your dancing eyes. I've got ya, and in the lingo of the gringo, I'm so hot, ya, muchacha, for...
Behold the chief of a bandit brigade. Behold a bandit who isn't afraid of anything but a Mexican maid.
en caliente.
Así.
Believe me if I told you I never wrote that review.
No, it was too brilliant.
Well, all right, I'll tell you the truth. I caught that recital at the tail end of a week's binge.
Oh, please go away.
Oh, Rita, please, I'm sorry. I was plastered and I apologize. Will you have supper with me and give me a chance to explain? 5 minutes is all I want, just 5 minutes.
All right.
You're an angel.
How much farther to Caliente?
Quien sabe? Who knows, senorita? Maybe 8, 10 miles. Maybe 12 miles. I don't know.
Hello, darling.
Hello, Larry.
Bring me a bottle of champagne, 1908 Clicquot and Scram.
Clicquot 1908 and Scram. Thank you very much.
Well, honey, am I forgiven?
I won't be added to a collection, Larry.
I don't know what you've heard about me, but whatever it is, I swear on my word of honor, you're the only woman in my life. You're the only woman I've ever cared anything about.
What about the beautiful blonde in New York?
Blonde?
Mm-hmm.
Say, now you by any chance haven't been listening to Harold, have you? Well, that fellow kills me. And of course, Harold is the type of man who exercises a peculiar, subtle sort of charm over women. And I suppose he thought it'd be funny to pawn his reputation off on me, you see?
In Caliente, welcome to you, and welcome
bring
to
all those
me.
Bags in.
You're welcome as you can be, in Caliente.
Larry, I would like to believe you. I will believe you.
Oh, Rita, you are sweet.
You're the sweet one, Larry. I'm so sorry I acted like this.
I'm the one to be sorry. I'm ashamed of myself.
You.
There's nothing to worry about now. There's just we two left. I'll get 20 years for this, but it'll be worth it. Bring it back later. 15 minutes.
Darling, I phoned you all the way across the continent. talk to me.
I can explain everything.
Yes, I know I'm drunk. It isn't a woman I'm seeing. There is no woman. Goodbye, Mr. MacArthur.
What brought you here?
The Trans-American Airline, you double-crossing. Who's that woman?
I'll tell you who that woman is. She's the one I'm going to marry.
Oh, that's what you think. Not as long as there's lawyers and justice in this world. I'll sue you for every penny you've got and plenty more, see?
Rita!
Why, that double-cross me, that
way,
huh? Scram!
Scram? What is this scram?
You!
Say, so what's this about Larry getting married?
Why, I never heard of such a thing.
Well, there's a woman in his room just now. He said he was going to marry her.
Rita!
I'm going to stop it, see?
And I'm going to help you, see?
Come on.
Sus vueltas.
Gracias.
Cuídese mucho, señorita.
Gracias, María.
Buen día.
Come, Jose.
Oh, Rita. Rita, I can explain everything. You don't have to believe me. Just listen to
Goodbye,
me.
Goodbye, Mr. MacArthur.
Oh, Rita. Rita, darling. Rita, if you want to listen to me, I can explain everything. Rita. Rita, will you listen to me? I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Rita. Oh, Rita, will you please listen to me? Give me a break, will you? I'm innocent, I tell you. Rita. Rita. Larry. Carson. Oh, she drives, too.
Come on, let's get after him. Here, get in here.
Yeah, driver!
No, driver! We don't need a driver.
Oh, no, you can't take a car like this.
Come on, quick, let me get here. Quick.
Policia! Policia! Clara, please, get your foot off that gadget. I'm driving this car.
Oh, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. They're getting away from us.
Haste makes waste. Rita. Rita, darling, this isn't fair. Oh, it's just silly to endanger our lives like this. Although, as a matter of fact, I'd give every penny of the $500,000 I have in the Merchants and Miners Bank to stop those two.
Oh, we'll stop them all right. What bank?
The Merchants and Miners. What's the matter? Are there any speed laws in Mexico? Uh-oh, here comes the law. Looks like a pinch.
Don't worry, my friend. There is nothing that I cannot fix. Fly on, my pigeon.
On second thought, I think we had better stop.
Speeding. That's a very serious offense in Mexico.
Well, we were only going about 32 or 30... Yes, Sergeant.
It calls for a severe penalty. And you are also guilty of stealing a car.
Well, I never stole a car in all my... Yes, Captain.
The penalty for that in Mexico is practically capital punishment.
Why, General!
Oh, but you see, officer, General, this charming gentleman and myself are eloping.
Eloping?
Eloping? Yes. Oh, no, we're doing nothing
of the... Yes, darling, yes. You don't blame us, do you?
We're doing nothing
darling.
Of the...
Darling!
Fine. My father, he's a magistrate. He'll perform the ceremony very reasonably.
Oh, that's marvelous. Lead the way, officer.
You stay right here.
You don't want to spend the rest of your life in a jail in Mexico, do you?
I've never been known to tell a lie in my life.
Ah, another wedding.
Wedding?
Si, senor. I just united this lucky young gentleman with a charming lady in marriage.
Congratulations, Harold, congratulations. You are my pal after all. You see, that's when he's at his best, back against the wall under pressure. What did I tell you, Rita? Childhood sweethearts, will you? Childhood sweethearts.
I don't believe it.
I never told you a lie in my life.
Darling, we'll spend a honeymoon right here in Caliente.
No, no, no. I've got to get back to New York. There's something about this Caliente.
Sure, it's palm trees, love, glamour, romance. Harold, it's just jangled nerves. A couple of days in this atmosphere and you'll be all right.
Now, look here, Larry. I don't like...
Well, what's the difference? I like it. Come, Harold.
This way, please. I will perform the ceremony most reasonable.
Senor, what do you call reasonable?
$10, I would call it reasonable.
Well, I will give you $20,
senor. Oh, $20, gracias, senor.
That is, of course, if...
If?
Do you happen to have a pack of cards with you?
Rita, now do you believe me?
Yes, Larry.
In Caliente, welcome you...
Darling! Here's where we're going to spend our honeymoon. Caliente, the land of flowers, romance, and you.
English.
perhaps not so good looking.
Where can everyone bring all their troubles and get